No, no, dig up, stupid. I'm Steve Dangle, back with another trade tree, and we're gonna talk about a deal that personifies digging up. Or you ever get like a zit, a blemish, and it won't go away? Quit picking at it. Or maybe to put it purely in hockey terms, if you make one bad trade, chances are you're gonna have to make a few more. Today, we're gonna look at how the Toronto Maple Leafs gifted the St. Louis Blues Stanley Cup champion, Alexander Steen. Here is the tree. Now, you might notice, wow, the Leafs side of this tree has a big old bunch of stuff on it, and the Blues one is looking kind of sparse. This is a good example of how sometimes less is more. Now, if you've watched one of these trade tree videos before, maybe you've seen the Chris Pronger one, I highly recommend you check that out. Alex Steen was mentioned in that video. Because before Chris Pronger was traded from the Edmonton Oilers to the Anaheim Ducks, where Pronger would end up winning a Stanley Cup in 2007, Pronger alleges that the Toronto Maple Leafs actually had a deal in place for him. And the story, as Pronger tells it, is the Leafs didn't want to give up Alex Steen in the deal. And why would they? In 75 games as a rookie in the high-flying 2005-2006 season, Steen put up 18 goals and 45 points. Now, that's not Sidney Crosby or Alex Ovechkin, who were also rookies that season, but pretty solid. The next season, only 15 goals and 35 points, but at least a fully healthy 82-game season. The next season, 15 goals again and 42 points in 76 games, so that's better, but it's not quite where he was as a rookie. But then, at the beginning of the 2008-2009 season, Steen's fourth season in the league, he had just 2 goals and 2 assists in 20 games. Now, you know what they always tell you in business? That's right, sell low. Alexander Steen, a former first round pick who, no, there's no way we'll ever trade him for Chris Pronger, he's far too valuable. He was a throwaway in 2008. Actually, funny little aside, so I didn't have a Leafs jersey at the time, and my girlfriend wanted to get me one. And she asked what name I wanted on the back, and I'm like, well, I could get Matt Sundin, but he's probably gonna retire soon. Oh, I know, I'll get someone who's gonna be here for a long time. Alex Steen. My buddy stepped in and told her to put Dangle on the back, but it still had the number 10, which was Alex Steen's number on the Leafs. And my buddy was absolutely right, because less than a year later, the Leafs traded Alex Steen to the St. Louis Blues. The trade was Alexander Steen and young defenseman Carlo Koliakovo to the St. Louis Blues in exchange for Lee Stempniak. Listen, hindsight is 20/20. I could tell you that trade sucked now, but at the time, it had all the makings of a fleecing. On the Leafs side of the trade, they had two players at the bottom of their value. Alex Steen, 4 points in 20 games. Terrible. Carlo Koliakovo, a defenseman and another former first round pick, having difficulty living up to that first round potential. He's a few seasons into his NHL career, and he just can't seem to stay healthy. On the other hand, there's Lee Stempniak. Just his second season in the league, he had 52 points in a perfectly healthy 82-game season, and 27 of those points were goals. Yes, you have my attention. The next season, just 13 goals and 38 points in 80 games. That's odd. And then at the beginning of the 2008-2009 season, when this trade occurs, Lee Stempniak had 3 goals and 10 assists for 13 points in his first 14 games that season. The Leafs were selling low and buying high. The Blues were selling high and buying low. Which team do you think won the deal? The Blues. It was the Blues. Carlo Koliakovo, disappointing first rounder, can't stay in the lineup. 29 points in 63 games with the Blues just that season. He played 73 games that season, which was a career high. And to that, you might say, well, there it is right there. 73 games is a career high. The guy couldn't stay in the lineup. The guy played 284 games as a member of the St. Louis Blues and put up 110 points as a defenseman. The Blues got value out of Carlo Koliakovo. A small asterisk on that, Koliakovo actually signed with the Detroit Red Wings as a free agent, and then a season later actually signed back with the St. Louis Blues. But does Koliakovo go back to the Blues organization if he didn't like it there in the first place? I'm gonna guess not. Now, Alex Steen. Oof. He's played 12 years in St. Louis and played in 765 games as a Blue. 195 goals. He's almost got 200 goals for the St. Louis Blues. 301 assists. He's got over 300 assists with the St. Louis Blues. And 496 points. He's almost got 500 points as a member of the St. Louis Blues. 144 of those are at even strength. He's a great even strength player. 42 of those goals are on the power play, so we know he's good on the power play, and 9 goals shorthanded. He plays in all situations for them, and he's done it for over a decade. He's never won it, but Alex Steen has received Selke votes as one of the league's best defensive forwards in 7 different NHL seasons, and in the 13-14 season, he even received votes for the Hart. Look it up on Hockey Reference. He got a 5th place vote, a 4th place vote, a 3rd. Someone thought he was the 3rd best player that season. Oh, and this past June, when hockey was played, Alex Steen hoisted the Stanley Cup. Then there's Lee Stempniak. No pressure, Lee. He comes into the Toronto lineup after the trade, and strangely, the guy who had never had any indications that he would be a point-a-game player in the NHL did not remain a point-a-game player. He lasted 2 seasons in Toronto. He put up 31 points in his shortened season after the trade with the Leafs, and the following season, he put up 30 and his Leaf high of 14 goals. And here's the problem. There's a reason that guys like Lee Stempniak didn't stick around with the Leafs very long at that time. The Leafs sucked. They were selling. They were getting rid of everyone. They had to recoup some assets on account of Boston had their first round pick that year and they were in the basement. So after making a bad trade to acquire Lee Stempniak, the Leafs tried to fix it. At the 2010 trade deadline, the Toronto Maple Leafs traded Lee Stempniak to the Arizona Coyotes in exchange for Matt Jones, a 4th round pick in 2010, and a 7th round pick in 2010. Now, Matt Jones is fascinating. He's difficult to find information on, but his last NHL game was in 2008, which you might notice is 2 years before this trade, and his last hockey game in the AHL happened in 2009. It's basically a roster space. The Leafs essentially traded Lee Stempniak for a 4th and a 7th. Not very good considering he was dealt for 2 former first round picks. But it's okay. You can draft good players with those picks, am I right? And actually, with both those picks, the Leafs did something smart. The Leafs traded that 7th round pick in 2010 to the Edmonton Oilers for a 6th round pick in 2011. I mean, what would you rather have? A 6th round pick or a 7th round pick? The Oilers must have really wanted Kellen Jones, who they picked with that 7th rounder in 2010. With the 6th rounder in 2011, the Leafs drafted Dave Brohl, the Brohldozer. Remember him? 6'2", 220 pounds, and he spent most of his days in the OHL and early days in the AHL punching other dudes in the head. Unfortunately, he only got into 5 NHL games with the Leafs, but he did get 1 NHL point, which is cool to be able to say. And, you know, it's the little things. Pat the Leafs on the back. All right, you got a 6th for a 7th. Okay, what are you going to do with the 4th? Another smart thing. Check it out, another smart thing. The Leafs made a 2010 draft day deal with the Washington Capitals. They had an earlier pick in the 4th round, and they traded it to the Capitals for their 4th round pick in 2010 and a 5th round pick in 2010. Now, this is what a lot of numbers guys say to do. Yes, you give up the earlier pick, but in the later rounds of the draft, they say it's smarter to acquire as many picks as possible. Because the value at the top of the draft is like 1st overall pick, 2nd overall pick, 3rd overall pick, and everybody else. Don't tell any scouts, but there's a reason a lot of people refer to draft picks as magic beans. With the 2010 5th round pick that the Leafs got from the Washington Capitals, 146th overall, they drafted Daniel Brodin, a forward out of Sweden. Unfortunately, he never made it to the NHL. He never even made it to North America, but I don't know. What are you going to do? Dump on them? You're not going to hit with every 5th round pick. It's all right. Here, what'd they get with the 4th? With that 4th round pick in 2010, 116th overall, the Leafs select a big right-hand shot defenseman. That's exactly what they needed then. It's exactly what they need now. That player's name? Petter Granberg. He played 1 game as a Leaf before being claimed off waivers by the Nashville Predators. Okay, so the Leafs got like 6 NHL games played out of the trade that sent Lee Stempniak to the Arizona Coyotes. All right, they blew it. Whatever, man, draft picks are magic beans. Like, here, I bet this will make you feel better. Who did the Washington Capitals get with the pick that the Leafs gave them? With the 112th overall pick in 2010, the Washington Capitals select Philip Grubauer. Woof Maron. Yes, it is good to get a sixth in exchange for a seventh. Yes, it is good to get a fourth and a fifth in exchange for a fourth. However, you gotta draft well once you get those picks, man. Grubauer was a pretty solid backup goalie in the Capitals system for parts of 6 seasons, playing in 101 games and throwing up a .923 save percentage. And he was even the Capitals' backup goalie when they won their first ever Stanley Cup in 2018. The Leafs love giving away future Stanley Cup champions. It's their favorite thing. And then after that, the Capitals rocked it. The Caps traded Grubauer, who looked ready for a starting job, along with Brooks Orpik, to the Colorado Avalanche in exchange for a second round pick in 2018. Now, the Avalanche kept Phil Grubauer, thank you very much, but they bought out Brooks Orpik, hence the second round pick in the deal, and Orpik then signed right back with the Capitals. He didn't even play a game for the Avs. And the Capitals used that second round pick in 2018 to select Cody Clark from the Ottawa 67s. Did it have to be 67 at 47th overall? Lee Stempniak, by the way, oh yeah, that guy, played in 100 games for the Arizona Coyotes, who the Leafs traded him to, and he scored 33 goals and 56 points for them before being traded to the Calgary Flames. Lankow then played in 73 games in the one season that he played with the Coyotes, putting up 11 goals and 30 points. Not mind-blowing, but the Coyotes kept getting value out of that deal. So, out of the 2008 deal between the Leafs and St. Louis Blues, who won? Well, the Blues got over 1,000 games played out of two players and a Stanley Cup. The Avalanche got something. The Capitals got something. The Coyotes got something. The Leafs got two incomplete seasons of Lee Stempniak and two draft picks who combined for less than 10 NHL games played. Like I said off the top of this video, quit picking at it. Stop trying to dig up. Stop trying to galaxy brain it. Actually, just stop. Why not? Just stop. You know who I feel the worst for in all this? Lee Stempniak. Because sometimes when you're involved in a really bad trade, all of a sudden people start to think, oh, that guy. And yeah, Stempniak had a pretty tough go of it because he played for 10, yes, 10 different NHL teams. But while he was playing for those 10 different NHL teams, Lee Stempniak played in 911 NHL games. That guy scored 203 NHL goals, 469 career NHL points. Nice. 99 times out of 100, the player doesn't stink, the trade does. This trade stunk. And at the end of all of that, Alex Steen is a Stanley Cup champion. And I had that jersey made into a chair. No, seriously, look. It was the old pajama jersey too, with the old logo. Even their jerseys sucked back then. It is a comfy chair though. So that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends that we got all kinds of stuff on this YouTube channel, man. We got lots more trade trees. We got some classic dangits. Some dangits from this past hockey season, because there was one and there still might be. We don't know. Just stick around and be safe.